We're going to do a song because the lovely Adele, who just did raffle there, and who invited us to play here, she did request that we did a couple of her favourite songs. And so we're going to do a song now that she's requested. Now, normally we only do this song. You're looking strangely at me, Boris. You all right? You're all right. You're feeling all right? Yes. We normally do this song as part of our Christmas show, because we have a Christmas show that is kind of completely different, really, to our normal show. But anyway, we're going to make an exception to the rule. So we're going to do this. It does require a certain amount of... we have to get into character for it. You know, it requires a certain amount of acting, and we're not really... It's quite hard for us. We're not really used to doing this. And so, unfortunately, the pantomime season is over, but we're going to pretend, we're going to bring ourselves back in time and pretend that it is January.
Oh, yes, it is.
So if you just bear with us just for 2 minutes, we'll just prepare ourselves psychologically to do the song. 2 minutes, well, 30 seconds. 20 seconds. It's very elaborate, Chris.
I don't know. So, I'm going to give you a good idea first.
Okay, now you do all know this song. You may not know that you know it. You've probably put it to the backs of the deep depths of the backs of your mind, hoping to have forgotten it, but you do know it. So we are expecting you all to join in. We may have forgotten it as well, because we haven't sung it since Christmas. A mouse lived in a windmill in old Amsterdam. A windmill with a mouse in, and he wasn't grousing. He sang every morning, how lucky I am. Living in a windmill in old Amsterdam. I saw a mouse.
Where?
There on the stair.
Where on the stair?
Right there, a little mouse with gloves on. Well, I declare, glory, clippity clop on the stair.
Right there.
He got lonesome and took him a wife. A windmill with mice in is hardly surprising. She sang every morning, how lucky I am. Living in a windmill in old Amsterdam. I saw a mouse.
Where?
There on the stair.
Where on the stair?
Right there, a little mouse with gloves on. Well, I declare, going clippity-clop on the stair.
Right there.
Oh, yeah. First they had triplets, then they had quins. A windmill with quins in and triplets and twins in. They sang every morning, how lucky we are. Living in a windmill in Amsterdam, yeah. I saw a mouse.
Where?
There on the stair.
Where on the stair?
Right there, a little mouse with claws on. Well, I declare, going clip, clippity clop on the stair.
Right there.
Oh, yeah. The mouse has disappeared. It was there on the stair a moment ago, and I don't know where it's gone. It's just Boris, have you seen the mouse anywhere?
We are here.
Ladies and gentlemen, have you seen the mouse? I don't know what you're talking about. There's nothing there. Where is it? See anything at all? There he is. Around of applause for Mr. Mouse. The daughters got married and so did the sons. The windmill had christenings when no one was listening. They all sang in chorus, how lucky we are, living in a windmill in old Amsterdam. I saw a mouse.
Where?
There on the stair. A mouse living in a windmill, so snug and so nice. There's nobody there now, but a whole lot of mice. We sometimes do forget, and then you do a very serious song after that.
With the ears on.
We wouldn't want to look silly, would we?
We're doing the Christmas show at Poynton on the 1st of December, by the way. That was a bit long ahead.
Thanks very much. Is anybody like me completely perplexed about life? About life? Yeah. I'm not really getting the hang of it, you know. As you get older, you're supposed to get wiser. I am getting older. I'm not sure I'm getting any wiser. That's what this next song is about. So it's a song called Get Wise, and it's about, I think the thing that stops us getting old, sort of, you know, and mentally, is to keep an open mind about things. And that's what this song is all about. Tolerance. Oh. Also, it's got Boris with his Bing Bong machine, of course, which is another reason we're doing it, because... For those of you that haven't seen us before, you've probably guessed by now that all Boris's instruments are homemade by himself, and they're all pretty amazing. And this one is his lowest budget homemade instrument, which is a little bit of a saucepan, which seems to have lost its handle, and some used hacksaw blades. So another reason to do this song is he gets to play this marvellous instrument.
Yes, the Bing Bong machine. There are only two of those in the world, surprisingly. have you patented it? Patented it.
Patented it.
You know what that means. I'm not surprising. I'm not really saying it very well. And it hasn't been patented, but for some reason it hasn't been copied by, you know, Yamaha. What is it? No, it's not. No. Yamaha or, you know, Stratocaster or anything. Nobody's tried to steal that design.
It's very surprising.
Yeah. It's a clear winner, I would say. And the only other one that exists... the only other one which exists is the prototype of that, and we gave that to Dave Pegg from Fairport Convention, because he's a wonderful bass player, and he's also an amazing man. He's extremely kind and generous. He's been really good and helpful to us over the years. And we thought the least we could do for him was to give him a rusty old sword gun with some broken hacksaw together. And it hangs on his wall, and he does use it every single day.
He does.
To make his baked beans in the morning. Yeah, he loves it. He's very pleased with it. Okay, what are we doing now?
Johnny.
Oh, Johnny. Yes, this is a sea shanty, except that it's not sung by sailors on a ship. It's sung by a sailor's girlfriend on the shore. And she's an optimist. It's good to be optimistic, especially in these times. You need a lot of optimism, don't you, at the moment? And she's so optimistic that she believes that her young man who's gone off to sea, he will come back alive, but he'll come back rich and a sea captain, and he will marry her. Good luck with that.
Yeah.
was a shoemaker, and did he heed of me?
Yeah.
Who won the cricket? Chris is saying. Who won the cricket today?
Today, one day international, England, West Indies. No.
I don't care.
You're all keen fans, aren't you? Yeah.
We're going to do a song about that we wrote about one of the founder members of the band, Churchfitters. The band has been going for a very, 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 very long time. We think that next year is our 40th anniversary. And none of us are founder members. But I was there pretty close after the beginning. There are two founder members. A guy called Jeff Coombs, who is responsible for the name Churchfitters, which you may be wondering about. Well, so are we. Because we've never really discovered why he chose the name Churchfitters. He's a bit bonkers, Jeff. So we ask him from top, because our paths still cross, because he lives in Essex and he still plays folk music. He plays mostly in a ceilidh band called the Hosepipe Band. Another one of his names. Yeah, he thought up the name. And so basically, Jeff is a bit bonkers, named us sort of in a very roundabout way after a road in Essex that he used to cycle through every day. This is what he told me. And when I said, oh, so it was Churchfitters Road, he said, no. So I thought, well, that's quite strange, isn't it? But he is quite strange. It's Churchfields Road. But so I don't know why he considers that he named us after the road, but that's the way his brain works. The other founder member was a guy called Anthony McCartan, who was born in Belfast, and an amazing guy, a larger-than-life guy. He was a giant of a man, a giant of a musician, had a beautiful deep bass voice, played every instrument really well, and wrote fantastic songs. And he just had masses and masses of charisma. You know, he was one of those people that could just walk into a strange pub he'd never been in before and spend the night there and end up best friends with everyone in the pub and not having paid for a drink all evening. You know, there are people like that, aren't they? He was one of those. And people that met him never forgot him. Even if they just met him once, he really had I don't know what he had, but he had a lot of charisma. And this song's about Anthony, who sadly died when he was just 50. And it was 10 years, the last but one album we recorded, it was 10 years since his death. And so we put some of his songs on the album and also we wrote this song about him. So he was born in Belfast, one to seven children in his family. His dad was a professional gambler when they were little. So, you know, money was definitely not constantly coming in. Life was quite hard. He had a lot of hard things. Anthony was a Catholic, but he was the first boy to go to a Protestant school. He was the first Catholic boy to go to his Protestant secondary school. He had quite a lot to deal with, really. And the family lived in a part of Belfast which was principally Protestant. And when the Troubles erupted, they got on really well with everybody. They didn't care what religion you were, what colour you were, anything. But when the Troubles erupted, they were just told to leave because they were no longer welcome in their part of Belfast. And they left Belfast and left everything behind and lost their house, lost everything. And they came to live in the south of England, and that's where I met him, in Brighton, back in the 80s, I think. So this song's called A Grain of Sand. Anthony was ill for a long time before he died. He was out in France with us. And he was absolutely amazing through his illness. He was hilariously funny and just kept everybody laughing and everybody's spirits up. But occasionally he got a bit down. And one day he was bemoaning the fact that he was frustrated he hasn't managed to achieve everything he wanted to in his life. And I was trying to assure him he had made a difference. And he said, no, I'm just a grain of sand. Martha. That's the title of this song. And I've written it as a chorus song because he adored chorus singing. And what he really liked about folk music was getting everybody to join in and have a go. So it's got a very easy refrain. You'll pick it up straight away. Really, really lovely if you'd all sing with us. And of course, Chris is going to play his beautiful glass harp again. Once knew your father, young man, and I can sing him as well as anyone can. Through many a tale, we have walked hand in hand, and the world was right when we sang. The world was right when we sang. In his Belfast home, there was mayhem and fun, and the wine flowed when the horses won, and the world was right when they sang. The world was right when they sang.
thank you very much indeed. We've got a big surprise for Richard now, because he's going to come and play mandolin with us.
Ooh.
He's not aware of this. We've never rehearsed, so be warned, but sometimes it goes quite well when you don't rehearse. I think he's heard of this song, at least. And it's, funnily enough, it's a song that Anthony, who we just sang that last song about, he used to love this song and he used to sing it regularly with us. It's called Will the Circle Be Unbroken? You'll know it. So you'll join in on the choruses. And,
and this is the last song.
It is the last song, yeah. I don't think we've ever invited anyone to play with us before. I can't remember. No pressure.
I think we have.
Yes.
Need to get as close to that as you can
for
the sake of it.
Okay.
What key is it in, Chris?
It's in A.
This is an A. Right. Okay. Here we go. Last number. And before we do the last number, and while Richard is tuning up, a big round of applause for Chris on the fiddle, the musical score.
Round of applause for Boris on all his amazing inventions. And thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And a huge round of applause for my big sister Rosie Shaw.
And also a huge round of applause to Adele and all the team who have just organised this gig. I'm standing by the window on a cold and cloudy day. When I heard the bus come rolling to take my mother away.
Mason,
be unbroken. To see you all again soon. We do have a Facebook and a website, churchfitters.com. If you want to find out more about where we're playing, you can look us up on those, and we'll be there at the end. You can also put your name on our emailing list if you want, just to find out about the UK tours. There's a bit of room for dancing. If anyone feels inspired, you know, do go ahead. Last one. Thanks very much, and I hope safe home, everybody.